night, week one at home against the Chargers. And then right away, no rest for the weary. 4 days later on Thursday night, week two, Washington hosts New York Giants in the first divisional game of the year. As the season moves along, how about the Saints in week five, the Chiefs in week six, and Green Bay in week seven? Definitely a tough stretch there. And the Bucs come to FedEx Field in week 10. Coach Rivera returns to Charlotte to face the Panthers the next week in week 11. And then down the stretch, four of the final six games on the road in Washington ends the year with five consecutive divisional games. Here it is laid out for you. The home games marked in burgundy. The bye week comes basically right in the middle of the season, week nine. The three primetime games come in week two, week 12, and week 16 against the Giants on Thursday night, the Seahawks on Monday night, football, and the Cowboys on Sunday night. For more details on the schedule, go to wavy.com and click sports. All right, and when it comes to big storylines of making his return to New England with the Buccaneers, Brady's 143rd regular season game in Foxborough will be his first as a visitor. The Buccaneers travel to take on the Pats October 3rd on NBC Sunday Night Football. No doubt, Gillette Stadium going to be jumping with electricity for that one. All right, read into this what you will. The Green Bay Packers are signing Blake Bortles, according to reports today. As of now, he's the third quarterback on the Packers roster behind Aaron Rodgers and Jordan Love. The 29-year-old former first-round pick spent last season with the Broncos and Rams. All right, how Vegas is this next story? The Las Vegas Raiders have plans to have a nightclub in one of the end zones of Allegiant Stadium. That's right, it's a deal with Wynn. The club will have a DJ, bottle service, tables, and couches, all the fixing to enjoy the games in Vegas style. Remember, the Raiders moved to the new stadium last season, but didn't have any fans at all throughout the entire year due to Nevada's COVID gathering restrictions. Owner Mark Davis and NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell have expressed optimism regarding full attendance at games this season. All right, college football news. Old Dominion announced today that the Monarchs will play their first ever game.